how Partridge is able to kind of slot in right in front of that 30. Ooh, gets in the 27. That's that a little bit of a combination of that bump, trying to slot in and waiting too long to get on the brakes, which you can find yourself in position they were. The caution's out.
Now, they didn't bring out the caution. Something else has, and as we get a look around the Shasta Speedway, we see there the 11 of Thomas Martin stop. There's Jack Sellers. He's got the big problem, damage to that left front.
Yeah, that's got the fenders all pushed in. It's not moving, and when that left front isn't rotating, you've got a really big suspension problem.
So Sellers will take the car off the track into the garage area. That's Matt Levine in the 14. He is around as well, and he's got damage. So Norman Levine Racing, not a good start to their night. Ron Norman with motor problems, started in the rear with a backup car, and now his teammate, Matt Levine, has got damage.
Yeah, and this damage actually looks a little bit more cosmetic, although we've seen a couple things dragging down there. It'll be interesting to see if they can pull some of that bodywork out and maybe continue tonight, but it's not looking good for them here tonight.
He'll have to go off for some repairs as the 14 of Levine will rejoin, and Rich DeLong has damage to the front end of his 84 car.
And as long as they didn't get into the radiator there with that the bodywork being pushed in, he actually looks like he'll be fine. This place isn't very hard on aerodynamics. You don't need them per se, so I think he should be able to continue tonight.
So, Parker, the initial race there, the caution comes out, and we see Rod Nealon has spun the 68 down to the infield grass. Nealon started shotgun on the field tonight, so he's been making his way from the back of the pack. Somehow got caught out here early on in the Bill Schmidt Memorial 150.
Might be having a little trouble getting it restarted here. We see that puncture there in the right front headlight, which can definitely be a sign of getting into someone's rear bumper and puncturing in there, which isn't a bad thing. It's not a bad amount of damage for a short track like this if you can get it restarted. Oh, and we are restarted there.
So Nealon gets the 68 car moving, and we will take a look at a replay to see what happened to him on this track. Damage to the right front, but it's like maybe someone else sent him a message. That's Thomas Martin behind him, top of the screen, and he sends him around.
Yeah, a little bit of a discussion about the real estate on this racetrack there. It just looks like just got into the bumper of Nealon and went around. I think at the end of the day, this is one of those products of being in a tight little track. I just think this does not bode well. Oh, and we've got a bit of a spin.
Caution is out as well. That's the 06 car of John Wood. And at the same time, the complexion of this race is changing. David Mayhew may have an issue in that 17 car. And as he goes down the backstretch, we'll see how long he stays out if he thinks it's something that's going to go away, but it looks bad.
Yeah. Really using it effectively. Let's see if he's just right there.
Whoa, oh, contact!
Johnny White gets in his left rear, and that's the risk you run of being on the outside. Gets spun out of the top five.
Carlos Vieira gets punted to the infield as well, but McReynolds brings out the caution in that 16. Tough break for him. He was running third.
He was bumped there by the chainsaw, Dave.
We talked about Johnny White's nickname, and perhaps McReynolds is now going to keep in his memory what they call Johnny White as he plows through the field. We'll get a look at that again as McReynolds was sent around.
Yeah, as we watch here, Johnny White, the chainsaw, as we said before, just getting in a little deep. I think, you know, a little bit Brandon coming down as well. I think they just connected, both fighting for the same real estate. And really, I'm not going to put a fault on anyone there, actually. I think that's just hard racing, being on the outside, trying to maximize all the grip you can out there and force the guys in the bottom as low as you can to hopefully get the runoff four to beat them.
McReynolds gets it right, and he'll have to rejoin at the back of the field. And we mentioned the seven of Gregson, now hearing reports that he may be serving. Yes, he's been sent through the garage.
They're looking on the inside as well of Raz. Maybe about to...
Whoa, contact behind him. That's Thomas Martin. He is around. Martin has had contact with a couple of cars tonight. You see Rich DeLong is around as well. And caution on the speedway again. That's Justin Funkhauser in the five. He's looking the wrong way.
Yeah, and Dave, what I found interesting here is we've had a couple spins now where they really haven't hit anything. You know, these guys have been spun out and able to continue going and continue their race with very little damage. And I think that's it's an interesting fact about the wideness of this racetrack. They're not getting all the way to that outside wall.
Take a look here.
Ooh, just...
Alex Shuddy into the back of Thomas Martin.
Yeah, just coming in there being a little bit more speed. The 11 didn't quite have the same speed and trying to use that front bumper to move him out of the way and just spun him out.
He was on the outside of Ryan Partridge, teammate to the leader, James Bickford, and trying to get his way through, found the back end of Thomas Martin's car.
Yeah, it's been a little aggressive there for Shuddy. I think, you know, you sometimes looks like...
We'll see who that was as this field still stays under green. It's Nicole Behar. Her car is around, and they have to bring the caution out now. She stopped in the middle of the track there.
Oh, yeah, here comes the leaders. They had to get that out quickly. See if she can stay on the lead lap, maybe beat Bickford here. It doesn't look like she can.
We'll see if they may give her the benefit of the doubt there.
Yeah, they might have given it to her there. That's good. And see the crowd going wild for that one. And that's what Eggleston has done here.
Look at Bickford drive that car, try to get it out. Carlos Vieira is around on the inside. The leaders have taken the white flag, and NASCAR looks like they're going to let him race back to the finish. Chris Eggleston is in turn three. He comes off of four. Chris Eggleston will win at Shasta Speedway.
A very important